In today's video, I've got a couple more Carl Friedrik products to show you. And what we're going to be looking at here is some of their wallets. Now, I have made a couple of videos with Carl Friedrik already. So if you want to see some of their larger items, like the bags, then you can have a look back at those videos as well. I'll put the links to those down in the video description. And as always, for full disclosure, this video has been made in collaboration with Carl Friedrik. So they've loaned me these items to show to you today, and I've made the video for them. So Carl Friedrik, if you're not familiar with them, are an English company based in London, and they design their product range down in London. In terms of manufacturing, that's done in mainland Europe. So most of the things are made in Italy, and then they have some other things made in Portugal and places like that. But it's not things that are sort of imported from the Far East. It's all kept within Europe in terms of the manufacturing. They make high quality items, and their business model is such that they sell their items directly to the consumer rather than going through any kind of intermediary shops or suppliers. So you're getting really a high level of quality at more of an intermediate price, and that's the general way that they like to run their business. They also really stand by the products that they make, and they give you a lifetime guarantee in case anything goes wrong with it. And they also have a 100-day returns policy, which is very generous. So if you do go ahead and buy something and then think, you know, this isn't for me, it's not right, or you're not happy with it, or you get kind of, you know, buyer's remorse, as people call it, or something like that, then there's that generous returns policy where you can actually send the items back to them for a full refund as well. Okay, so we're going to drop down onto the table now, and we'll have a closer look at these two wallets. We'll unbox them and have a look and see what we think. We've got two different types. One's a card wallet and one's a, you know, a notes wallet, a slightly larger bifold one. So we'll have a look at both, and we'll have a look at this one first. So I haven't opened these, as you can see, so you can see, you know, what the unboxing's like, or what you'll receive if you order one. I know sometimes people like to sort of see, you know, exactly what they're getting. So we'll carefully open the outside bit. And then we'll see what we've got. Okay. Okay, so we've got a little envelope inside the box. Let's see what this says. Ah, so this is a leather care guide that we've got in here. So this is going to tell you how to actually take care of your wallet. We're going to talk in a minute about the kind of leather that's in here as well. Thank you from Carl Friedrik. And that's signed by Mattis and Nicholas Opperman, who are brothers who actually founded the Carl Friedrik company. And then here we've got a little care guide. I won't read all the way through there, but that's going to teach you how to actually care for the leather in the item as well. You can always pause the video and read that if you want to. So why would they give you a leather care guide? Well, the kind of leather that's used in most Carl Friedrik products isn't necessarily the kind of leather that you would get in a lot of mass-produced items. So when leather's made, it's generally split into two different categories. It's either what we call chrome tanned, which is sometimes called mineral tanned, or it's vegetable tanned. The vast majority of the leather in the world is chrome tanned. So things like settees or sofas, whatever you want to call them, the interiors of cars, most furniture items, lots of things like that are going to be chrome tanned. A much smaller proportion of leather in the world is what's called vegetable tanned, and that's the original way of tanning leather that's been done for thousands of years. So rather than using lots of strong chemicals, it uses natural plant extracts, tree barks and things like that, different, you know, different items, and that creates a much more natural kind of leather. So if you pick up a leather item and you find that it's kind of, you know, it's got a really beautiful look to it, it's got that really nice leather smell coming off it, and it's got that kind of old world feel about it, then you've probably got some vegetable tanned leather in your hand. If something seems a bit more flat and it's odorless and that kind of a thing, then it's probably chrome tanned. So all of these items are made using Italian vercetta leather, which is a vegetable tanned leather. So you get that nice smell, you'll get the patina, and you get the quality that comes with the veg tan. So this first one we've got here is the Swanfield, and this is the card wallet. It takes around 7 cards, and it's designed to be a sort of a slim and compact item. And I think really lots of people now are moving towards just having a card wallet rather than carrying coins and notes around. And I also think that throughout the coronavirus and the various lockdowns that we've had, that attitude has probably accelerated as well, because lots and lots of shops weren't actually handling cash. So people got used to, you know, just using contactless payments all the time, and that's possibly a habit that will stick around. So size-wise, this measures around, that's about 7 centimeters by 10 centimeters, or for any American viewers, that's about 2¾ inches by 4 inches. So that's a nice compact design. And in terms of weight, this is around 48 grams as well. So this isn't a big heavy lump that you're going to notice in your pocket. So the design of this can take 7 cards, and what it's got is an interior, obviously, and then also on the back side here, there's an exterior card pocket. And that's formed by this piece of leather here, which actually wraps around the edge there and then comes up the back. So you actually get two different edges there. You get the stacked and painted edge, and then this has actually got a folded edge, so it gives it a little bit of a different look as well. These exterior card pockets can be quite useful for travel cards, metro cards, Oyster cards, bus pass cards, and things like that. Lots of those now are RFID cards, which means that you place them on some kind of a reader and the reader reads the card. Sometimes, depending on the wallet, if that card's buried inside, you'll find it doesn't tend to work with the reader. So you can then place it on the outside and it works more reliably. So an Oyster card, for example. Now, strange as this is, I have a little packet of cards that I use when I make my own wallets. And I have this in there, which I kept. It's 29th of April 2011 was when William and Kate got married. I'm actually filming this video on the 29th of April 2021, so it's their 10th anniversary today. So happy anniversary to the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge as well. I was actually in London for the wedding. I watched it on the big screen that they had in Hyde Park and everything. It's quite a nice memory. But as I say, if you place here some kind of a travel card like that, it tucks in nice and deep so you're not going to lose it. Then when you place that on those readers that they have in London or on the bus here, you'll find it reads without any issues. So one card on the outside, and then 6 cards on the inside, or thereabouts. So the inside here is divided up, as you can see, in 2 different ways. We've got vertical pockets there and horizontal pockets there, depending on quite which way you want to organize all your things. To keep the wallet slim, they've not made these pockets on this side individual either. So if I show you here, we've got a little piece of leather at the front, which forms its own pocket. And then if we look at the back here, we can see that that is actually just 2 cuts in the same piece of leather there. So these cards wouldn't, you know, fully separate in there, but they will stand off each other. We've also got a pocket behind there. So in total, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 interior parts there. So let's just have a look at how this loads up and see how the cards sit, which is quite important as well. All these kind of things will be quite stiff when they're new, and then the leather tends to break in over time, just like a new pair of shoes. Okay, so with those cards there fully seated, you can see that the front one sits down below the rear two, but the rear two do kind of cover each other up. And say we've got a section behind there. You could fold up notes if you wanted as well. You can put a card in there, as you can see. If you did want to keep a spare, you know, £20 or $20 note or something, you can always fold that up and tuck that away in these card wallets. Just so if you go somewhere and you happen to need that, then you've still got it. So I've actually got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6... and then the Oyster card would be in the back 7. So that would be with the 7 cards in there. You could probably squash a couple more in, but you can see that that's still pretty compact on the side. If we have a look on the side, that's sitting in there nicely. And it's just, it'll nicely fill your pocket, but it doesn't feel too bulky. It's not like people call it, the George Costanza wallet from the programme. So yeah, that's really nice. And I think a lot of cards now as well, you know, people can have kind of electronic versions on the phone. You maybe don't need 20 credit cards like people used to do. So if you slim down to your essentials, then, you know, that will work quite well. So there's 3 different colours of these. Remember, this is the chocolate one. There's other colours available. And what you can also get with this is the personalisations. So if you want your initials put in on it, or you want to get it as a gift, get somebody else's initials put on there, you can do that as well to make that kind of extra special. So let's move on and have a look at the other one now. That's going to be the larger wallet, and this one's called the Amwell. Okay, so we've got the same grey box on the inside with the logo on there. And then if we open this up, we've got the envelope again. I'm not going to open that one because these are going back. I imagine that's got that same kind of thank you note and leather care in. So this is the Amwell wallet, and the colour for this one is cognac. And I asked them to send these in two different colours so that we could compare. Obviously, we can't see the third colour. But if I just put the chocolate next to the cognac there, you can get somewhat of an idea of the difference there. But it's a nice light brown. And what you want to bear in mind as well is that this, again, will darken considerably with age as it kind of picks up, pocket sweats, oils off your hands and your fingers as you're handling it, and just the kind of general, you know, day-to-day life that something like this gets. It will darken down a lot and patina. Okay, so this is not a card wallet. This is a notes and card wallet. But the other thing that these can be very useful for is putting in receipts and things like that as well. So one of the things that kind of stops me fully going to a card wallet like this is that if you go to the post office, for example, you're posting your items off, you need that receipt for your business expenses when you get home. Where do you then start poking those receipts? So if you find that day to day, even if you're not spending that many notes, you maybe have other bits and pieces that you want to organise, then often this is useful to have that bit of extra organisation as well. Again, it's all really just personal preference. So if we see how this is constructed, again, they've gone for the kind of wrapped approach to the edge. So what they've done here is they've used a single piece of leather for the back of the wallet, which then comes around here and forms these lower pockets. And that's giving you a folded edge here. And then again, we've got a stacked and painted edge on the sides, which is quite nicely done there. Sorry, that's not a painted edge there. I think that's stacked and burnished on these ones. Yes, that just looks like it's burnished. So we've got the single piece folding around here, forming these bottom pockets. And then again, in terms of the cards, this part here is essentially just two slits. So there aren't individual pockets there. It's a single pocket with then a kind of a buffer, if you like, to separate those cards. Same on both sides. And then the interior here is undivided. So we've got a single note section, which is then lined with this kind of nylon type material here, which is in grey. We'll just see how the notes sit in there. Of course, notes are different in different countries. UK notes are quite a good example for wallets in terms of the depth. US currency is shorter than UK currency, and it's all the same size. So anything that UK currency fits in, US currency does. But if we pop a couple of notes in there to see the height, we can see that they nicely disappear right the way inside there. And then again, we'll just see how the cards sit in here in terms of stacking in. Okay, so the cards sit in there in a very similar way to how they did in the other wallet there. So these N2 cards are sitting kind of level with each other, and then the front one's lower down. So it would be a similar thing in that you would maybe want to put your less used cards in the back of there, because again, that's then going to be quite difficult to actually get that out without removing that second card. So often with a wallet here on the front, you might have, you know, three or four stacked sections where you see lots of pocket tops. That increases the thickness. What they're doing here is trying to give you that capacity for those six cards, but keeping the wallet as thin as possible. So it's a sort of a semi-minimalist design, if you like. And I think that works quite well, as long as you don't need more than about six cards. And I think of the colours, I prefer this colour here as well. I quite like the lighter colours. You can see a little bit more of the character of the leather in there as that ages.
So I hope you've enjoyed having a look at those items. I will see you in the next video, and take care of yourselves.